Hi everyone, this is Pierrick from P2design. Linking characters, rigs, and assets in Blender is super powerful, especially for larger scale and team-based projects. But it can be confusing whenever it's bugging, especially when it comes to character rigs. In this video, I will show you all you need to know to get comfortable with linked assets. Let's get started. To link an asset, you simply need to go to File and click Link. Linking allows you to use any data. It can be a character, a mesh, a material, an animation, or even a full collection from a Blender file into the current Blender file. When you use the Append or Link function, you can enter the Blender file and see its structure. And we can easily understand that a Blender file is some kind of project file, including all the actions, animation, material, meshes, all the data you would use and create inside this Blender file. When loading your Blender file, Blender will search for the linked data. So if you rename the source Blender file, Blender will still show a dedicated data block, but it will be empty, and you may have an error message. The outliner is the best way to spot those missing data. You can switch the view mode to Blender file and check for any warning sign. Then right click and choose relocate. This way you will be able to browse and find the renamed Blender file from which you've linked any data, and the problem will be solved. Linking is super beneficial because a linked data can be edited in the source file, and it will automatically be updated in all the Blender files and scenes that used this asset. Let's take a character as an example. An animator will likely work on the linked version of a character. In the meantime, the character designers and riggers may still be working on that character, changing its color, changing its material, its shape, or even its rig. When the animator gets back to work the day after, Blender will automatically load the updated version of the character. Another great feature is that the animator won't be able to accidentally modify the model or the rig. And if 10 animators are working on the same character in different shots, for example, it's more likely that they will have the same version of it. The same values and benefits apply to environment pieces. You may just have a blocked out version or a previsualization of an asset. And while you are working on the animation, on your previsualization, the environment team can work on that asset. Once they have updated it, it will also update wherever it has been linked. When you want to link an asset, it's super important to be well organized, especially when working with a team. You should use collections with clear naming convention and hierarchy. I advise to use a master collection as being the linked asset and use sub-collections to store the rig, the character, its equipment, etc. To me, it's easier to work with collection than objects, as you can add or remove multiple objects from a collection, while an object can only store its own data. I will create a new empty file and I will link my character. To do so, I will link its main collection that includes the two sub-collections with the ring and the different objects. When I'm browsing my source file, the collection use alphabetical order. That's why it's important to have a good naming convention to identify them easily. In my case, my master collection is written in full capital. I'm using the Trident character taken from my animation course Alive, the most extensive animation course in Blender you will find. But you can also get this ring, among others, for free on p2designacademy.com. Back to our linked file, so we can see our character. If I go in Previs, I can see the materials. But when I select it, it selects everything. The character, the weapons, the rig. Because what we see here is a simple empty object instancing a collection. The Master Trident character collection I linked. If I now try to link an object, his spear for example, I will be able to see the object in 3D, it's considered an object, but I can't edit any of its data. I can't enter edit mode, I can't change the order of the modifiers or add any of them. To be able to expose the whole hierarchy and get access to the read, I need to right-click on the collection. Here I can create a library override by choosing Make. From there I can choose to do an override of only the selected asset, its content, so the whole hierarchy, or the asset and its content. I will select content so that all the collection and their content will be exposed. Now you can see that I have access to the different mesh object, but also to the rig. Now I still can't edit any of the data. I can't edit my character mesh. I can edit the container, moving the object in space, but I can't edit what's inside. But I can use the rig. I can't edit any previously created animation with that rig that were linked, because those are data, so you can see that they are grayed out, but I can duplicate them and create a new action from an existing one, and from there I can start animating with my character. But armature are kind of an exception, because when we are manipulating an armature in pose mode, we are currently not editing the base or core data of the armature. We are moving sub-object of the armature, but it's not like editing the armature. So I can't enter edit mode on my armature, and I can't enter edit mode on my character mesh. You may have spotted a couple of different icons near your different data. The first one is linked data. There's an instance of the data from another Blender file, but you can't modify them. The second one with the arrow is the library override. It's still a linked data, sourced from another Blender file, but some of those data inputs are exposed. Here my Trident material is linked. I can't do anything with it. To be able to access it, I need to select my Trident mesh, right-click on the object, then choose Library Override, Make and Content. The content of this object is now overridable. And the icons near my data has changed. Previously, all the material inputs were grayed out. I couldn't edit any of them. But now I can change anything in the material. I can change the value of my hue and saturation here, or I can add new nodes if I want. But if I want to save the file and then I reload it, I will lose those modifications. So those material data are exposed right now. I can modify them, but only temporarily. As soon as I reload my file, Blender will reload the material data that are stored in the source file. Here I'm modifying the shader, I'm adding a new node, I'm saving it, and when I reload the file, I'm losing what I have done. So a library override allows you to modify some of the exposed data, but they are not stored anywhere because you are sourcing another Blender file where you are not saving those modifications. So you may think that's shitty, but in the end it prevents you from making mistakes on the shader, on the mesh, on whatever data. But while you can't modify them, you can animate those data, because an action or an animation in Blender is not the modification of a data. It's just information that are stored into that action and then read by the shader in that case, but it's the same with the rig. When creating an animation for a rig, we are just storing transformation information for the different bones that are then read. Regarding the material here, it's kind of a hack, so I don't advise you to take that road. If you want to animate any data related to your character, then I advise you to use custom properties. And in the specific case of a rigged character, bone custom property. On this specific rig, I have custom properties that allows me to modify the material, to change its intensity and to trigger dissolve. You can learn to create this dissolve material in this video. Custom props can be created on any data block in Blender. It means they can be stored in the object, in the mesh data of the object, on a material, on a texture, basically any unique and editable data block. The same goes for armature. It can be stored on the object armature, the armature data, or the bone. When you're rigging, I advise you to use the bone to hold the custom properties. Because when you are animating with an armature, Blender will create an action to the bone level. It means the action will store the transform information of the bone, but also the custom properties of that bone. If you create and key custom properties at the armature level, for example, it won't be stored in the same action. So if you use any animated custom prop like inverse kinematic to forward kinematic or the material I just showed you, well, you will import the action in another Blender file or edit the action in the current file. You may lose the synchronization or it's gonna be complicated to keep those in sync. So let's see how we can use linked custom properties. You can edit a custom property to change its type, change its name, etc. So I will create a custom property on my bone and call it property link just to make it easier to follow. You can give it any name. And I will save this Blender file as being the source file, for example. I will create a new Blender file and I will link this armature object. As explained before in the outliner, I will make this a library override by right-clicking on it. Go to library override, make and choose selected and content. Now I can go into pose mode on that bone, but the custom property is grayed out. By default, a custom property is not overridable. To make it overridable, you have to specify it. So I will reopen my source file. Edit the bone custom property and check library overridable. If I now reload my Blender file where I linked this single bone armature, the custom property is there and I can change its value, so I can animate it, for example. If you learned something new or you think this tutorial was beneficial, please consider giving it a like, dropping a nice comment. I don't like to ask, but you know that's the best way to support the channel. And don't hesitate to subscribe. If you've already been using linked assets, especially rigged characters, you may have met this weird issue when you reopen your file where the character is linked, it looked all distorted and destroyed. Keep calm, your file is not corrupted or whatever. And it's a pretty easy fix. Here you can see my robot is quite distorted. To fix the link issue, I simply need to right-click, go to Library Override, Troubleshoot, and choose Resync. As I do so, Blender will refresh the link and check out the source file, and basically fix the bug. You now know the basics you need about character linking and asset linking in Blender. This is the end of this video, and I'll see you in the next one.